In this module and the next one, we are going to learn about two very important financial instruments, publicly traded stocks and bonds. In the resources section, you will find a link to a general definition of financial instruments. For our purposes, you can think about a stock as an ownership interest in a company and a bond as a contract between two parties in which one party promises future payments to the other. Financial instruments that are readily tradable, as is the case of publicly traded stocks and bonds, are referred to as securities. Bonds are securities that governments and corporations sell to raise money from investors. Investors buy bonds in exchange for a promise of future payments. That is, when investors buy bonds, they are essentially lending money to the government or corporations that sold them these securities. Investors receive not only the amount they lent, but also an interest on it. We study bonds in this course for several reasons. First, a very large number of corporations all over the world, and most governments, use bonds to raise money. These markets are huge. For example, the value of total outstanding bonds at the end of 2016, issued by the US Treasury alone, was $13.9 trillion. It is important for you to be familiar with these markets. Second, we can use prices of government bonds to calculate what is called the risk-free rate, which, as we will see later in the course, is a critical input to valuation. Finally, this module will serve as an application of the use of the present value and IRR concepts that we learned in modules 1 and 2.